Good evening, students. So today we will discuss the actual digestion process. So first we will list out the various parts of alimentary canal, and then we will have a look out at which part of alimentary canal is involved in the actual process of digestion. Because we know that there are some passage parts, there are some tubular parts in the entire alimentary canal which are not involved in any part, or they are not involved in any process of digestion at all. So the first part of alimentary canal is the mouth part. So mouth leads to pharynx, then pharynx leads to esophagus, clear? Esophagus leads to stomach, stomach leads to small intestine, small intestine leads to large intestine, and large intestine opens into something which we call it as anus or anal opening, and through this anus the undigested waste material is discarded or it is removed out from the body. So let us first discuss about the mouth parts. What are the actual process of digestion takes place in the mouth, then we will lead to each and every process or each and every part of alimentary canal which is involved in the actual process of digestion. Now let us discuss about the mouth parts. Okay, so first, that is digestion in mouth. So the name of the topic is digestion in mouth. A, that is digestion in mouth. So mouth is mainly involved into main processes. The first one is the mastication, that is the grinding of food within the oral or the buccal cavity. And the second one is the facilitation of the swallowing, that is what we call it as deglutition. So mainly involved in the two process are, that is first one is mastication, and we know mastication is the grinding of food within the buccal or the oral cavity. The second main important process, or second main important function of digestion that takes place in the mouth is deglutition. Let us write the simple term deglutition. D-E-G-L-U-T-I-T-I-O-N. Deglutition means the process of swallowing the food with the help of tongue. So main the two parts of the mouth are teeth and tongue. We have discussed these things in detail. So teeth is involved mainly in the mastication, that is the grinding of food within the buccal cavity. And deglutition is the process of swallowing the food with the help of our. Now the third structure, which is an important structure in case of mouth part, is salivary gland. So salivary gland is also an important part. Now why salivary gland is an important part? Because we know the three salivary glands, the paired salivary glands, parotid, submandibular glands are present, as well as sublingual glands. Three salivary glands are there within the buccal cavity or the oral cavity, and we know that these three salivary glands secrete something which we call it as saliva. So salivary glands secrete something which we call it as saliva, and the composition of saliva is, the major composition is water. So saliva composition is 99.5% water is present in the saliva, and the remaining percentage comprises of, so saliva comprises 99.5% saliva is made up of water. Okay, then the remaining part is mainly occupied by ions like Na+, K+, bicarbonate ions, etc. And the two most important enzymes, if you remember when we talked about the salivary gland separate section, two most important enzymes in case of saliva was lysozyme as well as salivary amylase. So two enzymes were salivary amylase and lysozyme. Now these two enzymes play a major role. Actually, the main digesting enzyme is salivary amylase. This enzyme has antibacterial role. This is bactericidal in nature. So let us discuss first the role of this enzyme. Now, what this salivary amylase will do? As soon as we intake the food from our mouth, that is, we take in the food into the buccal cavity or the mouth parts, what we observe, with the help of teeth, we masticate the food. That is, we grind the food and we convert these food into small particles. This will increase the surface area for more and more absorption or for more and more digestion. and then with the help of tongue we swallow the food into the pharynx and then we lead to esophagus. So salivary amylase's main role is to convert the starch present in the food into maltose. So salivary amylase's role is to convert starch which is present in the food. Now what is the starch? Starch is the complex carbohydrate. Starch is complex carbohydrate. It is also called as polysaccharide. Okay, polysaccharide. If you remember, saccharide means sugar. Saccharide means sugar. Poly means many. So many such sugar molecules join together and form one big molecule of sugar, and that is what we call it as polysaccharide. And starch is a polysaccharide, and it is made up of glucose units only. Starch is a polymer of glucose. Many such glucose molecules join together and they will form something which we call it as starch. This starch is converted into maltose. And what is maltose? It is a disaccharide. So maltose is disaccharide, which is again made up of glucose plus glucose molecule. Di means two, saccharide means sugar. So two sugars, which two sugars? Glucose will make one molecule of maltose. So salivary amylase main role is to digest starch in our mouth into maltose. Salivary amylase major role is to digest starch in our mouth mainly into maltose. So salivary amylase is also called as carbohydrate splitting enzyme. So this may be asked in your exam for 1 mark objective or in the NEET. Salivary amylase is also called as carbohydrate splitting, or you can also say carbohydrate digesting enzyme. So what is the meaning of carbohydrate splitting or digesting? It digests, it breaks starch into maltose, it splits starch into maltose. Okay, and near about 30% digestion of carbohydrates, 30% digestion of carbohydrates takes place in mouth. So the digestion process, actual digestion process takes place or starts within the mouth or the buccal cavity only. And what is the percentage? Near about 30% starch digestion, that is the carbohydrate digestion. That means carbohydrate means the sugar molecules takes place in the mouth. Now lysozyme, what is the role of lysozyme? Lysozyme, we know it is antibacterial, it is bactericidal in nature. It kills all the bacteria which are there in the food so that the clean food should go into our alimentary canal. So this is all about the process of digestion in case of mouth. Once again we will recapitulate. Mainly mouth has the salivary glands. These salivary glands secrete something which we call it as saliva. The major composition of saliva is 99.5% water. Certain ions also, Na+, K+, bicarbonate ions. Salivary amylase and lysozymes are the two major enzymes which are present in the saliva of human beings. Lysozyme is acting as bactericidal, it is antibacterial in nature. Lysozyme is antibacterial in nature. Now what is the meaning of antibacterial? Against, anti means against. It works, it kills the bacteria, it works against the bacteria. Clear? And salivary amylase is also called as carbohydrate splitting or digesting enzyme. What is the main role of salivary amylase in our mouth or buccal cavity? It digests starch into maltose. Starch is a polysaccharide, clear, and maltose is a disaccharide. Di means two, saccharide means sugar. Okay, so two sugar, which two sugars? Two molecules of glucose will make one molecule of maltose. Okay, and near about 30% digestion of carbohydrates takes place within the mouth or the buccal cavity only. So the actual process, the main digestion process starts in the mouth only. That is about for carbohydrates I am talking about. Protein digestion does not start in case of mouth. Now mouth leads to pharynx. That means food which is produced in the mouth is what we call it as bolus. So food is the technical term, the biological term is called as bolus. bolus means the circular sticky food, circular sticky food in the mouth, which is produced after mastication and after this process also. So bolus is circular sticky food produced after mastication or the digestion in the mouth is called as bolus. Now this bolus is circular in nature. It can easily go to the small size of the pharynx as well as esophagus, where no digestion takes place. If you remember, pharynx and esophagus act as the passage for the food. Clear? And the main function which is involved here, pharynx and esophagus, mainly esophagus, is the muscular movement of food. And that muscular movement is what we call it as peristalsis. That muscular movement is called as peristalsis, P-E-R-I-S-T-A-L-S-I-S, peristalsis of food. If you remember, we have discussed when we were discussing about the esophagus. What is peristalsis? The movement of food within the alimentary canal. So this is all about the process of digestion in case of mouth. In the next part, we will study about the process of digestion in case of stomach.